Hey, what's going on, guys? Daniel from Modbot here, and it's been a while since I've done a video on just a 3D print. I used to do videos where I kind of did little time lapses and I would showcase a specific 3D print, and I haven't done that in a really, really long time. Well, I recently got the InStone Inventor Pro into review, and they sent me this roll of filament. They sent me this roll of filament with the printer, and it actually was included inside the box. And this is the nicest spool of filament I think I've ever received in a inside of a 3D printer box. So this is their Pro Blue PLA, and I printed a couple of little prints with it, and I decided to myself that I needed to do something kind of epic and really awesome to one, test out the quality of the printer when it comes to PLA, and to actually do something cool with this blue filament versus just my usual kind of benchmark type stuff that I print. I first discovered this thanks to 3D Maker Noob Joe. He posted this on Twitter some months ago, and I am a huge fan of Howl's Moving Castle. I love the movie. It's one of the few movies I actually own. And when I moved out from my parents, it's like the only movie I actually brought with me. So when I saw Joe post this months ago, I initially had planned on printing it out, and I just never got around to it, or I just didn't really, just didn't do it. And I decided that this was the perfect time to finally print this out. So this is Howl's Moving Castle by a person named CMAG on My Mini Factory. So I'll place a link in the description if you do want to actually download this model. It prints in two main body parts, and then a bunch of tinier parts. I had to do three main body parts because the printer didn't have the height that I needed, so I imported it into Mesh Mixer and sliced the top part into one more chunk. All in all, it took about 40 hours to print, I think. And I was having one issue. I was having a couple issues, not with the print, but with the kind of post-processing of this to put it all together. I didn't have any super glue, so I was trying to use my two-part adhesive, and I was having a hell of a time getting things to actually stay. The stuff I use is, it says 60-second set, but I was having to put a lot of pressure for about 5 minutes for each part to even get it to stay kind of in place. And so I got really frustrated with that, so I went ahead and got some Loctite super glue, which was definitely the way to go. I highly recommend it. It worked a lot better. But the feet on this were just too brittle and weak to be able to support the weight of this thing. I mean, they're really, really thin feet. So I went ahead and measured the bottom portion of this of Howl's Moving Castle, and I just really quickly in 360 Fusion designed this stand. It's just got kind of a little Y-shaped hook that goes underneath it that I then used a combination of super glue and two-part adhesive and this little base part, and now all the weight goes onto that, and it sits beautifully. So I definitely think this is one of the most beautiful prints that I have printed out to date. It is just awesome, the amount of detail. The blue color looks fantastic. The model is just immaculate. So I just wanted to showcase this print to you guys. So I'm just gonna go ahead and kind of let the print speak for itself. I'll get some close-ups and some various shots of this with some nice little music for you guys. And again, links to the printer, the filament, and the model will be in the description of this video. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you guys next time. Peace, guys. We'll be right back.